all of us try our best to be as good as possible. Some of us are able to grow in goodness, while some of us struggle to grow in it. Irrespective of our degree of goodness, we look for the good in others and hope the best for them. When we see them falter, especially those whom we cherish the most, we are taken aback. We somehow find a way to reach out to them. But little do we realize that in our eagerness to help them back on track, we may end up destroying the cordial relationship we had with that person in the first place. This could lead to a permanent scar which is beyond repair. Jesus, in today's gospel, proposes a method which would be beneficial in dealing with others. Jesus' method is simple, yet sometimes it could be quite challenging. In Jesus' opinion, if we come across a person who has wronged us, the first approach would be to confront the person directly and come to a common consensus. If that doesn't happen, he asks us to go with one or two witnesses and talk to the person concerned. When that too doesn't work out, he asks us to approach the church or the community to which she or he belongs. And finally, if that fails, Jesus asks us to leave the situation as it is. Simple, isn't it? Jesus comes up with a very simple solution which we have unnecessarily complicated. He considered their backgrounds and treated them with dignity, which made even those considered as outcasts by the society to follow him. Jesus didn't want to complicate things and desired that we treat our brothers and sisters with the same love. But have we been able to do so? How many times we have spoken about others behind their back? How many times have we made the person aware of their mistake? And after making it known to them, how many of us have given them the freedom to decide for themselves when we don't see the result immediately? How many times have we forced our corrections on others and failed to look at them with love? It's quite hard, as many times we have forced our opinions on others, leaving them scarred for life. Many times we have failed to understand what makes a person behave or act in a certain way. Sometimes we also find it hard to let go and cling to our opinions and perspectives. But Jesus, through today's gospel, is asking us to be more patient in our dealings with others. He is also asking us to respect the other person's boundaries, to be more empathetic, and to grow in the grace to accept corrections. As Jesus rightly puts it in today's gospel, "If on earth two of you are united in asking for anything, it will be granted to you by my heavenly Father." Let us pray for one another and ask for the grace to grow in empathy and understanding for one another and build communities of peace and love. As Johann Wolfgang von Goethe said, "Correction does much, but encouragement does more."